Next up, we're going to make these torches. It is rather dark in here, it has to be said. Ah, we get four pair, per single stick and single charcoal used. So actually we've got tons of torches now. And how do these... Oops. And there we go. Oh, that's nice. As the light kind of rolls across the land. Okay, right. I'm still not completely 100% sure of what's going on, what's happening. So we've removed this walled city mod, which means we're not going to get old ruined cities generating in the world, which is kind of a shame. I'd quite like to see, apparently it's quite fascinating to come across this giant walled city, but apparently what can be done is off camera we can install it, go and explore the world until one generates, and then uninstall it again, because once it's generated, you know, at the minute it's sort of sitting there taking up processing time and memory, saying, you know, are we going to generate one here, are we going to generate one here, and every time I move and new land is generated, it then has to run through the whole procedure of checking whether it's going to generate a city on that new land. Which was just obviously it, you know, I don't want to insult the person who wrote the mod. I mean, you know, these people often do these things for free. I mean, even if they get advertising money or that kind of thing, it amounts to sort of being paid you know, a few pennies for what is hours and hours and hours of work, tens or even hundreds of hours some of these people spend doing this. Well, I've done it myself, I've done mods for games. And you do, even if you're earning advertising revenue for even the most popular mods, you might earn, you know, £40 a month, you know, $60 a month. Which you are you're putting in, you know, 200 plus hours per month to earn that money, so these people are not doing this for financial gain, and so I don't want to insult him, but the person who made that walled city mod. But obviously on my system it wasn't working out, so it did have to go. I like that there's a window in the door, I wasn't expecting that, and I can kind of see out. It's horrible weather, and that is absolutely bucketing it down. So really I am off script now. The sort of walkthrough the first day that my friend gave me, that actually ended up being the walkthrough the first 2 days and nights, I've come to the end of that, which is in building this torch. I really think you may have overestimated how many torches I need. He gave me instructions to build 250 odd torches, and I needed one, but that's fine, doesn't matter. Okay, so some mobs are down there on the beach, look. This might be when my door gets tested. Okay, there's one. I have my baseball bat ready in case he just walks through. I am half expecting that to happen. So the priorities for tomorrow is Well, I have. I think this pork chop's just going to stay in there. I don't think it's going to go mouldy or rotten or anything. I hope. So, the priority is we need to. These are making noises like I heard earlier down on the beach. So, yeah, as it says, I'm getting thirsty. So the priority is I need to. Is that a? That's a dog, and I'm pretty sure it just killed that sheep. So obviously the animals have their own little ecosystems going. They hunt as well. Yeah. So the priority really is to we've got to find cows. We've got to kill cows to take their leather to make a water skin so that I don't die of thirst. That's the first priority. The second thing, I think then I'll be able to. Oh, that's much better. That rain is really loud. The second thing, I wonder if that dog is owned by these zombies. They don't look nice. They don't look friendly. Oh God. Surely a dog can't open the door. Or a wolf, I guess it's supposed to be. Yeah, so priority one, kill cows, make water skin. And then priority two, we're going to make a bigger house, because this is getting a little claustrophobic. We've got our chest. I'm going to put everything I don't need in the chest. We'll keep some torches. I think we'll keep 8 with me. I'm just going to wait for daytime. Oh, we can. Here comes dawn. So, as it gets light outside, I wonder if it's worth. Okay, that one doesn't have a head. These are definitely zombies. All right, totally saw me then, even though he doesn't have a head. He wants in. Shall we give him a taste of a baseball bat? Oh God. Right, so those zombies are fairly. Actually, did do a lot of damage to me, so I'm not going to say he's fairly harmless. He's fairly easy to kill, but he also caught me quite badly. I'm going to have another pork chop, even though I'm not hungry, to heal me. Right, there are more bones down here. I think those skeletons, and probably the zombies too, burn in the daylight. I think that's why we need shelter at night, but not at day, because they burn up in the daytime. Which is quite cool, actually, so... But, definitely, I think twice now, I've been attacked in the day by those ones who explode. Come here, piggy. Okay, we keep jumping to swim. Can I get out of here? Nope. Get out of here. There we go. Right. Oh. So yeah, we're looking for cows. That is the main task. I'm going to stick to the coast again so I can easily find my way back. Here's my quarry. I've got plenty of stone at the minute, back at home. We just want some cows. You know, I'm sure this grass here only grows in the bright sunlight. It doesn't grow under these big trees where it's darker. That's excellent. What is that thing supposed to be? It's got a big... Oh my god, it is not friendly. Okay, and there's another one. Whatever they are, they drop food, pork chops. And there's a few more of them here. Fairly easy to kill. So, whatever those things are, they're not. Maybe they're territorial, maybe that one was attacking me because I was on his territory. But I'm not taking the risk, I'll just kill them all, especially as they give me food. Oh, there's a ton more of them here. Oh, damn lad. Son of a bitch. Right, well, as he's not attacking me, I'm not going to attack him. So, we might need to... That looks like a penny bun mushroom. Suppose that's what it's supposed to be. It's a real pain that these pork chops don't stack. I guess that's a balance issue. I guess it's because otherwise you could just stack up with tons of food and basically rain down. You could still stack up with a load of food. But not quite, but 64 times less than you could otherwise. Ooh. Well, I guess, I wonder if, do you want to just, can I push you? Can you just jump in there for me, little piggy? How about you? Do you want to just show me what happens if you go in there? Nothing good.